Today we're discussing the 277 Fury Hybrid,
its two-part case design, its comparison to 556 NATO, and how it changed SAAMI's maximum pressure standards.
Hi, I'm Ben, this is Benny. This is episode 24. Thanks Snapdragon for suggesting this video. Let's get into it.
General information. The 277 Fury, also known as the 6.8x51mm, is a centerfire bottleneck rifle cartridge invented by SIG Sauer in 2019. The 277 Fury is based off the 7.62 NATO, neck down to 6.8mm, and has the shoulder angle moved forward and increased to 30 degrees. This is a hybrid cartridge with a brass body and steel case head to allow for extremely high pressures.
History.
The 277 Fury was designed for the US Army's Next Generation Squad Weapon Program and was released in the XM7 rifle and XM250 automatic rifle. The plan for this cartridge and weapon systems was to replace the 5.56 NATO M4 carbine and M249 light machine gun. Enemy body armor is constantly improving, causing the 5.56 to lack effectiveness, whereas the 277 Fury would increase armor penetrating capabilities at extended ranges. Performance. SIG's published data shows that their commercially loaded ammunition can propel an 135 grain bullet at 3,000 feet per second, 140 grain bullet at 2,950 feet per second, and an 150 grain bullet at 2,830 feet per second, all out of a 16-inch barrel, which matches the 270 Winchester with a 24-inch barrel, which is impressive. To get these ballistics, the 277 Fury uses a hybrid bimetal case at extremely high pressures. This cartridge has a steel case head and brass body. The steel case head allows for much higher pressure than standard brass does. A brass case with the same pressure would blow out the primer pocket, causing gas to escape and damage to the rifle. Before I jump into the comparison, if you would like to be part of the email group, where I share the next few cartridges coming up and some other bits and pieces, fill out the contact form below. Comparison to the 5.56 NATO. The 277 Fury is significantly heavier and produces heaps more recoil than the 5.56, all for the trade-off of having better armor-piercing capability at extended ranges. But if you look at recent conflicts, drones account for over 80% of combat casualties, so a rifle's ability to penetrate armor is practically irrelevant, so you probably would be better equipped with Grandpa's shotgun. Downsides. This high pressure could become an issue. SAAMI's original maximum pressure for modern rifle cartridges was 66,000 PSI, but the 277 Fury got approved for an incredible pressure of 80,000 PSI, all thanks to its steel case head. When the 277 SIG Fury was submitted to SAAMI, some committee members protested the idea of a cartridge loaded to 80,000 PSI. A big concern was letting something like the 277 loose on the consumer market with those unfamiliar with its limitations. The problem comes down to chambering a rifle in 277 that wasn't designed for it, potentially causing the rifle to explode in the shooter's face under high pressure. This is a similar problem for the military. Can you safely convert existing 7.62 NATO guns to 277 Fury without risking catastrophic failure? Probably not. If you look at the differences in lug dimensions from the AR-10 to the SIG XM7, there is more than 30% increase in the locking lug length and shear strength in the SIG. Therefore, you could assume that the safety margin for many existing 7.62 NATO guns would not be enough. Ian from Forgotten Weapons has a great deep dive video on the SIG XM5 where he shows the dimensional differences. I will link that below and you can go watch that if you haven't already. What do I think of the 277 SIG Fury?
I like it as an innovative concept.
Part of me thinks it'll have the same fate of the many other projects that have failed to meet widespread adoption, many of which I'll cover at some point.
Let me know your thoughts on the 277 Fury and where you think it'll go.